So we're going to talk about the gradient today. The gradient takes the partial derivatives and puts them in vector form. So it shows up in all the fundamental equations of nature. So how do we get to the gradient? Let's start with a function of three variables. The gradient is intrinsically a three-dimensional object. So we have a function of x, y, and z. And if we look at the differential of f, so what is the change in f when we change x and y and z an infinitesimal amount? That's our df. And remember, we wrote this in terms of partial derivatives as partial of f with respect to x times dx plus partial of f with respect to y times dy plus partial of f with respect to z times dz. Now I want to put this in vector notation. We can do that if we make use of the dot product. This is equal to the dot product of two vectors. The first vector is df dx along the I direction, the x direction, times the I unit vector, plus df dy times the j unit vector, plus df dz times the k unit vector. This vector dotted into dx times the I unit vector, plus dy times the j unit vector, plus dz times the k unit vector. Remember, the cross terms are all zero. I dot j is zero, I dot k is zero, j dot k is zero. And the I dot I is one, j dot j is one, and k dot k is one. So when you take the dot product, this is the expression. So now we have the dot product of two vectors. This first vector is what's called the gradient. So we write that as the gradient of f. That's the definition of the gradient. And that's dotted. This second vector, remember our r was xi plus yj plus zk. So this is just what we call dr. So this is the infinitesimal vector dr. Okay. So we have defined the gradient. This then is the definition of the gradient. What is the meaning of the gradient? So this function is maximum when del f is parallel to dr. So you get a change of f by varying r. So if you want to get the maximum change of f, you have to vary your motion in the direction of the gradient. So the gradient gives you the direction. This is a vector. The direction of the gradient gives you the direction of the maximum change of f when you move a little bit dr. Okay? That's because this dot product is maximum when del f is along the direction of dr. Okay. Another way of writing the gradient is to a formal notation. We write this del all by itself as a differential operator. We can write that as I times d dx plus j times d dy plus k times d dz. That's maybe something you never saw before. This is called a differential operator. It's useful sometimes in doing some algebra with these gradient. Okay, I should say that this has a name. This operator goes by the name of Del. D-E-L, Del. So the gradient of F is sometimes called Del F, Del F. Okay, let's look at an example. So let's say that F of XY equals XYZ. F of XYZ, I should say, equals XYZ. Let's compute the gradient of F. So del F is going to be the partial of F with respect to X, which is YZ, in the I direction, plus the partial of F with respect to Y, which is XZ, in the J direction, plus the partial of F with respect to Z, which is XY, in the K direction. Okay? A very simple computation of del F, or the gradient of F. Okay, so let me summarize. We're trying to now put partial derivatives in a vector. That's this del operator, also called a nabla symbol. If you use LaTeX, you need to use nabla. But in spoken language, we call it del, after the Greek letter. It puts the partial derivatives in a vector form. This is a differential operator form. But when you act del on a function, then you get partial of f with respect to x times I plus partial of f with respect to y times j plus partial of f with respect to z times k. And then I worked an example. Okay, we'll be seeing a lot more of the del operator in this course. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.